Welcome to our Football Officials video training series. We're studying the National Federation of High School rules and five-man mechanics. This video is produced by the Arkansas Association of High School Officials. We're helping good officials get better. Technical assistance provided by Dax Hill, Greg Downham, and George Demetrio. Our producer is Matt Bibbin. Executive producer is Walt Coleman. And I'm your host, Todd Allen.
All right, welcome back. Let's get right into it. I've only got three plays this week. I'm a little bit short. Just one of those tough weeks for me. Didn't get the time that I wanted to spend on this project. So an abbreviated version this week. We'll make up for it next week. With this play, we start. The quarterback just fakes a little inside handoff, then tries to dance on the inside, and then ends up bouncing it out and running down the sideline. And this is just a heck of an athletic move, this guy here. And so then we have a couple of blockers out here and a couple of defenders. And the first defender just falls down. He's not even blocked at all. So I don't think that this is the block that we're officiating as far as this flag goes. But then this block here. Now, let me stop it right there. Because I want you to remember what we talked about, players in chase mode. These guys are head up, right? So this player is not coming. The blocker's not coming from a chase mode. But he does end up with some contact in the back. Most of it's on the side. But there's not a lot of contact here at all. But this is certainly not a block in the back. But we do end up with this flag and a call for a block in the back. And as we look at this on tape, there's really only two possibilities that we called this action here against the goal line, a block in the back. Or we called a block in the back on the defender that fell down and wasn't even blocked. So I'm at a loss on this one. I don't know what it is. But what I wanted to show this play and talk about and just reinforce chase mode and understanding what it's like for chase mode and go over that. If a player is coming from chase mode to block, he can have absolutely no contact in the back. But if he is coming from a position other than chase mode, as long as all of his contact is not in the back, if he starts on the side and then goes into the back, that is fine because that is the defender turning away from the block. And it may not be a deliberate act, but it doesn't have to be. So not coming from chase mode, we just want some contact in the side. But coming from chase mode, you can have absolutely zero contact in the back. So those are two very, very different scales that we want to weigh these blocks on. But in this one, there's just nothing here. I don't know what we call, and that's a little bit frustrating for me, and it's extremely frustrating for the teams. So let's make sure that you see everything. Do not officiate what you think you saw. Make sure you saw it. Better to have a miss on a block like this than take down a touchdown on a really good play. All right, before we look at this next play, let's just glance again at 9.4.3N, like Nancy, which says no player shall execute a blindside block outside the free blocking zone with forceful contact unless initiated with open hands. Pretty straightforward. We remember from last week, we talked about that free blocking zone, just being that 4-yard by 3-yard box, the football being the very center of that box. When we talk about blindside blocks, there are some things that we like to look for. One of the things we talk about is players that are swimming upstream. So let's take a look at this play. And we'll talk more about players swimming upstream in just a second. But quarterback brings a man in motion. He's moving right to left. Just puts the ball in the old bread basket and away he goes. We've got two blocks to look at, really. And that's this first block right here, which is straight up, good blocking. And then let me back it up just a little bit because I want you to focus on this player. And when I talk about swimming upstream, look at the ball carrier. He's coming this way. And then this blocker is running this way. So he's moving to the inside. So head linesman, this player ought to jump right out at you. Because you ought to treat this player like he's got a brick in his hand. Because when a player's going inside and the ball's trying to get outside, something bad's going to happen. It's just not a good position to be in as a ball player. So we'll keep an eye on this player right here and watch this block right here. All right, so there's a couple of questions. We got to know what's forceful contact. Well, this guy raises him up and puts him on the ground. I certainly think the element of forcible contact is here. He is outside the free blocking zone, and this block is not initiated with open hands. This is a very good look at a blindside block, and we miss it. And I think that we miss it because we may both have gotten on this inside block. Someone just didn't pick up this player, didn't recognize that he's swimming upstream, didn't recognize that he was moving inside with a brick in his hand, and then we miss this action. So talk about these plays in your pregame. This is another good one to look at. And talk as a crew about who's watching what. And for our line of scrimmage officials, this is a good one to recognize a player swimming upstream and just focus on him a little bit longer, make him your key, and watch. I think you'll pick up this action for what is a textbook illegal blindside block. All right, let's wrap it up with this last play. And we've started this play. These are tough. Let me start with that. Because we've got trips to the top side and twins on the bottom. So a five receiver set, empty backfield. We know we're going to send five guys down the field, and we're going to try to cover those with the two line of scrimmage officials and the back judge. Just a big difference between the five and seven man mechanics that plagues us when we're trying to officiate these plays. But I really honestly don't think that's what bit us in the hind end on this play. As we watch the quarterback just straight drop back and dump it over, as we set up this bubble screen on the top side, and we've got one engaged blocker here, and this guy's still in space, so we don't even need to officiate him. And the receiver drops to catch a low ball, and it looks like from this angle he gets his knee on the ground, but he comes up and runs, and you guess what happens? How did you know that? You're absolutely right. He's going to run this for a touchdown. So let's go back to the end zone shot, and I think here we get even a better look at this. And you can see from this player's knee is, his entire leg is on the ground. This player's down immediately when he catches this ball. It would have been better for him to not catch it, because this should have been a loss of yardage on the play. But we know how it ends. And of course, then we get a coach's question. How do we defend this? Absolutely not. So let's talk about ways and what we're looking at and how we're looking at this. I want to go back to the wide shot. And back judge, I expect you to be here on this block. And I'm also going to put the referee on the hook here too, because with the quarterback absolutely in no jeopardy at all, you could rotate and help with this and maybe catch it. Although, you know from these videos, I always hate for the referee to look away, because we really don't have an official on the line of scrimmage on the backside who could take a sneak peek at the quarterback. So if he gets hit late and the referee gets caught up looking at this, we're in trouble. But head linesman, there's just absolutely nothing else to look at. And it's so critical with the ball coming low, you just gotta feel this is coming and focus on this receiver catching this ball. Although he's in space and there's nothing there. But we also have the issue of forward backward, which the referee again could help on. So I don't wanna make light of this. It's a tough play because the head linesman's looking up the field on blocks, with the back judge also helping on that. Referee, you're trying to kinda want to stay with the quarterback too, which I kind of understand that. But this is a play that we've got to get. Referee, could you be wider? If you're wider, do you have a better look? Because there's a possibility you could focus on this and have the quarterback in your peripheral vision, and then look on, make a ruling on forward, backward, also this knee on the ground, and then come back to the quarterback if you need to. Again, don't want to make light of it. It's not easy to officiate football. It's really not easy to officiate football played really well when you only have five officials. So I get that. But this is a play. I want you this week to play this in your pregame with your crew. I want you guys to talk through it. It's real easy, and don't get caught up with, well, we wouldn't have missed that. I know that's what you're going to say. But I'm telling you, good officials can miss this call. It's fundamentally how you work the play. Are you fundamentally getting in the correct position, and do you know what you need to look at? Do you have a feel for the game of where your attention needs to be? Because if you do, I think you get this play right. But if there's any breakdown at all, and we end up with no one looking at this, we don't see it, and this play that should have been a loss for yardage goes in the book as a touchdown. Tough play, but I think we can learn from it. All right, that's it for this week. Sorry, again, a very short presentation, but just a tough week for me, and I know you understand that. But we will try to have a few more plays next week as we continue to drive on in this first week of competition conference-wise for us here in Arkansas. I think it's important to put out that the game's going to be faster. The intensity's going to be higher. You as a football official have got to ratchet your game too. Don't have rabbit ears. Don't go looking for trouble. Just work every play mechanically sound. Raise the level of what is a foul. See everything that you call, but don't call everything that you see. Find that correct balance so that you get the fouls that involve safety first. You get the fouls that have a big effect on the game. You get the major fouls, the stuff that's big and shows up on tape. And talk your way through the little stuff. That's what you got to do. I know it's tough. Here's my email address if you have a question or comment, or would just like to let me know how your crew is using these videos. I always love to hear from you, toddallen65@gmail.com. For the Arkansas Association of High School Officials, this is Todd Allen saying I hope to see you on the field real soon.